Well, I hate to do this, but let's get on with it. It's something that's got to be done. This is the final comparison that I'm going to be doing for the trifecta versus native soil. I wanted to show you this from start to finish, and this is pretty much the finish because it's the end of the season for me. I don't expect to get too awful much out of plants with the growing season that I have. These plants aren't going to be able to put out flowers and produce full-size fruit by the end of the season. It's just not going to happen. So what they have now, I know you're there. Yep. Get over here. Yep. Isn't that adorable? Yep, I've been saving frogs from Rascal. Don't tell him I'm here. But I've been saving frogs from Rascal and putting them into my garden where he can't get at them because he doesn't go into the raised beds. And they're having babies. Yep. Okay, well, I just wanted to show you that because it's adorable. Hey, say hello to my friends. And he's, oh, there he goes. I had to take a break. It's frog break. Okay, let's go back to the experiment. At the beginning of the season, I used a product done by a fellow gardener, and his name is my gardener, and he sent me a sample of a product that he put together, and it was called Trifecta Plus. And it's a powder that people refer to as pancake mix because it just looks like pancake mix in a bag. And he wanted me to try it out. And I told him I'll do it under the stipulation that I'm going to give honest reviews as I see them. I'm not a scientist. I'm not going to do anything scientific. I'm just going to do it the way that I see fit, that I think is fair to the product and to my viewers and to my garden. He agreed to this. So here's what I did. I dug up a piece of ground over here. I dug up a piece of ground over there. I mixed in Trifecta with this one, and I mixed absolutely nothing with the other one, nothing at all. And I planted two almost identical pepper plants. Thing is that pepper plant was bigger than this pepper plant. So I figured, well, with the trifecta, the plant should at least catch up with the other plant. And I've done updates on that. And you saw that this plant did actually have a little growth spurt and it caught up with the other plant, which I thought was pretty good. And that's what the first update was. I thought, wow, doing really good. And then the trifecta one, it put out two early peppers. Yes, it did. And these peppers, by the way, let me get you in close because I want you to see exactly what's going on with this experiment, okay? Pardon the weeds, but that's just how it goes the end of the season. This is a Nardello pepper plant, and these are the two peppers that were produced by it this season. That's all it produced. Now, the effect of the trifecta on this plant was, from what I saw, it caused it to grow really quick for a short time, and then it caused it to start flowering for a short time. And I made sure that I came out here every day and pollinated these flowers. I wanted to make sure that the plant had every benefit to put out every single fruit it possibly could. Same thing with the test subject. I pollinated those by hand as well. Well, the trifecta put out these two beautiful fat Nardello peppers. Yep, they are beauties. This is what a Nardello pepper is. It's a long, sweet Italian grilling pepper that's absolutely beautiful. Nardello pepper plants only get around 18 inches to 2 feet tall. So this plant is, from top to bottom, about 2 feet tall. Yep, it got, well, yeah, about 20 inches tall, almost maximum height, but that's all it did. Once it put out those two peppers, it stopped flowering because what happens is, and this is what I believe happened with this plant, it started growing, it started flowering, but it produced early. And normally you want your pepper plants to grow up to be a good size. And that's why I say prune them and everything. I didn't prune this, but I want you to grow your plants to full size, then allow them to flower. It's very tempting to let them put out peppers right off the bat. But you know what? Once they put out peppers, it's a lot of stress on the plant. That plant has to support these huge babies. And that can cause it to slow down on growing and slow down on flowering if the load is really heavy. And that's what Nardellos do. They're a very large pepper. So what happened is the stress of the mid-season, the heat, caused this to not flower. It had stuff to produce. It stopped growing. It did nothing. it had two peppers and that's all I got from one plant. And I don't really think that that's a whole heck of a lot for one plant in a garden. By any stretch of the imagination, I think you should probably get more fruit. So what I believe happened is Trifecta caused this to fruit early, and which in turn caused it to not be able to give me a second crop this season or a bigger crop once it got bigger. Now let's take a look at the test subject. This one here is the test subject. It grew in nothing but the soil. I gave it absolutely no fertilizer whatsoever, no compost tea, no nothing. All I did was I gave it water every time I watered the Trifecta one. And this one grew to, I believe, well over 2 feet, like maybe 2.5 feet. And that is maximum size for a Nardello pepper, from what I understand. It grew really tall, and it did put out flowers when the other one did. So I thought, wow, the Trifecta is doing really good. It put out flowers, it put out fruit. Well, this one didn't put out flowers right away, which is what I expect of my plants. It grew to full size, and by the way, it's still growing. Yeah, it's still growing. I can see new growth coming out all over the place, and it didn't put out flowers right away. And that was early in the season, but when the heat of the season came on, generally my pepper plants won't flower. So it took a break, it didn't flower, and then right when the heat broke, it started to flower down here. And it's also putting out some new buds for the fall crop. So I got my midsummer and my fall crop going on. So I'm gonna have some peppers up here, but look at what it put in here. Come in close and take a look at the peppers on the test subject. Yep, these are Nardello peppers and they are long. The other one had nice fat peppers and I gotta give them that. This one has the nice, long, beautiful Nardello peppers. This one's not as big as the Trifecta. This one's not as fat as the Trifecta, but it's longer. But ooh, look at what we got here, folks. We got a third. Yes, we do. Now, so what I ended up getting, ooh, I'm getting a mosquito too. Go on. I'm filming. Okay. Smiles, everyone. What I ended up getting off the test subject is three peppers. Three beautiful peppers, which quantity wise, of course, is more than the Nardello that was taking the Trifecta. And this plant is still growing. It got bigger. It's putting out flowers at the top. And I looked very close with my glasses, by the way, at the Trifecta. Not a single flower is on top of that. So it's not going to flower in time. This one took its time. It grew naturally and it didn't get anything to really give it a boost and shoot it up there. And it grew naturally, put its roots down, got the nutrients it needed, and then it did what nature wanted it to do. Get strong, put out flowers. Whereas I believe the Trifecta was fed really quick, so it caused it to produce fruit sooner than it actually should have. And one last plant that wasn't in the experiment, but I want to show you the way that I normally grow my peppers. This is a raised bed that has compost that I make from my chicken manure and my grass clippings and my leaves. Basic compost that I use in all of my garden. This is the exact same type of Nardello pepper. This one was pruned, so it grew nice and strong, multiple growing branches, like one out here, one here, one here, one here. It is a nice sturdy plant, and I want to show you up close what this does with compost. Okay, let's start at the very top. You can see, if you look really close, little buds that are about ready to come out with flowers. Yep, that's my fall crop. A little farther down, these have already flowered and they're starting to form peppers. And then let's move, well, I guess I'm gonna have to turn the camera. Let's move down and let me show you the peppers that are already forming and growing. These are all the Nardello peppers all over the place. Right here, down here. And oh yes, they're even hidden down in here. There's some down here, back around here, little ones that are still forming over on here. And let's not forget this one way back here. Ugh. Let's try not to snap them off. Nardello's down here, over here, and there's, I believe, one. Yeah, there's one underneath here. Yeah, they're everywhere. They are absolutely everywhere on this plant. It is loaded and it's able to hold this amount of fruit. It's able to support this amount of fruit. And by the way, Remember? Yeah, a lot of you may be thinking to yourself, isn't this the plant? Yep, this is the plant earlier in the season that I got the huge harvest from. So this is actually my second harvest this year. I had an early harvest, then when the heat of the summer came on, it slowed down with the flowering, but I poured on the compost tea, I kept it fed, I supported it like my other plants in the garden. It put out flowers, and I was out here pollinating those things when the bees and the little tiny insects wouldn't come out from the heat. I came out here and I pollinated them myself, and I got myself another harvest. You can see that it's even going to be putting out peppers all the way into the fall. This plant is a producer. One little seed produced me enough peppers to get me through the winter. Okay, here comes the hard part, folks. I'm going to have to give you my honest appraisal of what it is. And as much as I dislike doing this part, it's what I agreed to do. And so I'm going to do it. I don't much care for what the trifecta showed me. And I know that people will have good luck with this. There are a lot of people that say, hey, I like it. And that's fine. I always say whatever works for you, do it. So if trifecta is working for you, knock your socks off. More power to you. I hope you have the best success in your garden. For me in my garden, with a test that I did, the way that I did it, I did not have luck with it at all. It caused my plant to fruit early, caused my plant to fruit early and to just waste its energy early on and not give me anything in the long run. Whereas the test subject, the one that didn't get it, it took its time and it put out fruit naturally. And then when I compare that with what I can get done with compost, There is absolutely no comparison to what good old-fashioned compost can do. And by the way, when you're talking about spending $8 for a bag of powder, and you're going to be putting that in your garden here and there, I'm thinking for $8, I can go down to my local Lowe's, Menards, Home Depot, any kind of garden center, and for $1.50 a bag, I can get me a 40-pound bag of manure. Yes, I actually priced it before I filmed this. A 40-pound bag for $1.50. You can get 5 40-pound bags. That is a stupid amount of manure. And you can take that manure and put a big heaping handful into a 5-gallon bucket, mix yourself up some manure tea, let it set overnight, and water your plants all summer long, and give your plants a real healthy drink of something that's natural and something that's good for the soil. And when you're done with that manure, you put it into your soil, mix it in, that's going to feed the worms, which are going to feed your soil, which is going to feed your plants, which is going to feed you. That is the chain that I always go by. Take care of the soil. And this stuff is a powder that's all mixed together and is supposed to feed your plants. Well, I don't garden that way. I garden by incorporating good stuff, compost and mulch and things like that. I take care of the soil. And when you put in powders like that, it really doesn't do anything for your soil in the long term. You want instant results and you're impatient, you might want to use Miracle-Gro, you might want to use Trifecta if you don't want to use Miracle-Gro and go a little bit organic. It could work for that. And I do believe that there's a use for Trifecta, possibly in potted plants where you don't have that natural symbiotic relationship with microbes and all the other good stuff in your soil. It could work in a potted plant, but in a garden like this, I don't believe it has a place, and I don't believe that I'm going to use it again. Really sorry, I couldn't give an endorsement on that. But if it's something that you want to use, go for it. For me, it's just not for me. I'm going to stick with my compost. I'm going to stick with manure. I'm going to stick with a natural way of doing stuff and not rely on some kind of magic bullet to get my plants growing. I really don't believe in that kind of stuff. So with that being said, let's get on to something a little bit happier. Thanks everybody for joining me. Thanks for everybody for joining me in the garden to show you the plants, the harvests, these creepy little cucumber plants that are putting out stuff, and I'm glad I could show you my Kelsey onions. I was really proud of those. I was really happy. I was really surprised, and I'm going to grow those again. Sorry about all that rambling on. I just had to make sure that I let you know exactly what my thoughts were on this product and what my thoughts were on how it worked in my garden. And I'm going to take the onions and cabbage in, and I think I'm going to figure out something good for dinner tonight. Thanks everybody for joining me in the garden. I really do appreciate it. Have a great day. Bye.